Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shoub, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shoub, and this morning we'll be talking some golf, we'll be talking some travel, got some deals and some news on travel for you a little bit later in the show, and joining me here in the studio, of course, is Mike McGann of Legends Radio. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Dan. How are you?
I am doing great, and you?
I'm doing pretty well. It seems to me that looking at you, the future's pretty bright. We'll talk about that in just a little bit.
We will, and unfortunately the weather's not cooperating much this weekend, but there's golf somewhere to be played, so we'll talk about that.
Of course.
And of course, also joining us on location today in parts unknown is co-host professional golf tournament director Doris Muscarella. Good morning, Doris.
Good morning. Happy Sunday to everyone.
Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday.
I can hear in her voice she's wearing something very stylish.
It must be. She always is.
She always
especially
does.
When she's out and about.
That's so. Doris.
she's the best dressed tournament director in town.
She's just, yeah.
Absolutely. You got to make it look good. You might not be the best golfer, but you got to make it look good.
This is true. This
I
is
love
true.
It. She sells it, man. She's got it.
And also, in just a few minutes, we're going to be chatting with a guest, a fellow by the name of Jake Duhaime. He is the marketing guy for a company called Uswing Eyewear, and I was lucky enough to wear them while playing golf, actually, with Doris last weekend. And I think I was looking quite marvelous, but more importantly, I was able to see because the clarity is just incredible. And I enjoyed it, so I figured I'd share it with everybody else so
those
that you
cool.
can enjoy it, too.
Those are cool.
They're very cool, and the name on it is actually CT Pan. He endorses them as well as Rose Zhang, but CT okay. I actually had a chance to play with not so long ago, a few years back. Pardon me, so it's kind of cool wearing the same sunglasses as him. But first, why don't we talk a little bit about what else is going on in the world of golf. Last week was the Players' Championship, and Scotty Scheffler was the winner, just barely. Almost got himself into a playoff. Clark actually was Wyndham Clark.
The lead.
Yeah,
he was the lead for a long time.
He did. He fell back, and then on 18, he hits a putt from I don't know about 15 or 17 feet or so. I think it was. And it rims the cup, goes halfway around, and comes out.
Oh.
That cost him somewhere between $500,000 and $2.5 million. Had he gotten into a playoff and won, it would have been $2.5 million. Even if he lost, he would have had second place by himself instead
sure.
of a tie.
Right.
So that would have been $500,000. Talk about, I mean, that, the rub of the green, I guess you could call it.
I just don't
it.
Have the words
he,
for
he,
that,
yeah,
though.
He couldn't have hit it better. It was half in and came out.
Pop.
It was just horrible. pardon me. Also, on the Asian tour, actually, we don't typically follow it that closely, but a fellow by the name of John Catlin, he has 3 wins on the DP World Tour and 4 Asian Tour wins, shot a 59.
Wow.
Exactly. There's a handful of players that have shot 59 in competition. He's now one of them. It's amazing, a 59, so congratulations to him.
Right.
Finishing up later today, not too far from here in the Tampa area, the Valspar Championship, hopefully, depending on weather, of course, as the weather is not so good. Also, the LPGA Tour is playing in California, Palos Verde, and the Champion Tour is in California, too, the Hogue Classic. So all of that will be finishing up later today, hopefully. pardon me. Jay Monahan conducted a meeting with the Saudis on this past Monday, and they were happy to announce that they've got pretty much nothing to announce.
I'm happy to hear that announcement, actually.
So, we'll see what happens with that. John Rahm came out with the Masters Club dinner, and no surprise, it has all sorts of tapas and other lovely Spanish cuisine. That's his prerogative to do that, and of course, he's lucky enough to play in it since he's on the LIV Tour, too, but he can play in majors if he's, you know, qualified.
Yes.
He's the defending champion, of course, so he'll be there.
Good.
pardon me. Gary Woodland, who recently we had mentioned, I think he won an award for his comeback from health issues. He's still struggling, so sorry to hear that. So-Yun Ryu from the LPGA Tour, after 13 years, has announced her retirement. So congratulations on that to her.
Enjoy.
Yes. All right. I think what we are going to do is we're going to cut and take a quick break, and we're going to bid adieu to Doris because we're going to get our guest on the line, and then we'll get Doris back on afterwards. So in just a minute or two, we'll be talking to our guest, Jake Duhaime from Uswing Sunglasses. You won't want to miss it. And in a little bit, we'll be talking to Doris. And so hang in there, Doris. And we will talk to you in a bit. And we'll take a quick break. So stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
When you put one in the hole, it's like a victory.
Hi, Golf and Travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
Doris Muscarella here. When I'm not co-hosting the Golf and Travel Show, I'm Southeast Florida's leading business and certified golf tournament consultant. I provide comprehensive solutions to all aspects of a golf tournament. From planning, management, marketing, administration, and logistics, I take care of the big picture or the smallest detail. With a passion for golf combined with years of experience as a golf tournament and event consultant, I organize events that exceed expectations and raise the bar of excellence. Your business or charity deserve no less. If you're ready to host a remarkable golf tournament that will leave your clients, players, donors, and spectators in awe, call me, Doris Muscarella, at 954-240-4853. That's 954-240-4853. Or simply visit my website, golfcharitytournaments.com. That's golfcharitytournaments.com.
Went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee, wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
And we are back, and as I mentioned, had a chance to wear these new sunglasses from a company by the name of Uswing, and played golf with co-host Doris over the last weekend, and I was just amazed at how clear they are and how comfortable they are, and I think I look pretty stylish. I don't like to judge myself.
Did it just get cooler in here, Dan?
I guess so, as I wear my sunglasses
on,
indoors.
And all of a sudden, the coolness
know,
level.
In
the, no, those are awesome.
But more importantly,
guy.
They're also endorsed by CT Pan, who I had a chance to play a round of golf with several years back. So I thought it would be pretty cool to be wearing the same glasses as him. So I wanted to share it with all of you listeners out there. So I figured I'd get the expert from the company to talk about it with us. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome Jake Duhaime. Jake, how you doing?
Well, thank you guys for having me.
It's a pleasure. So these sunglasses, obviously, besides being stylish, they're made for golf. Besides CT Pan, you got Rose Zhang, who's another hot, young, up-and-comer. But there's so many sunglasses out there. There's so many for everything as well as golf. What is it that makes these sunglasses so special, in your opinion, coming from the company, that they're breaking into the world of golf in a big way all of a sudden?
Well, it's a couple things. I think the most important thing you noticed it as soon as you put it on.
Mm-hmm.
They're very, very light. Mm-hmm. So when you're talking about playing 18 holes, And a lot of people like to take their sunglasses off because they don't want the weight on their face. They don't want to deal with glasses moving back and forth as they're swinging. They're just 21 grams. So carrying that on your face over 18 holes really is not bad. It feels like you don't have anything on most of the time. The other real key is, especially on the putting green, these are very, very high technology golf sunglasses that eliminate some of the distortion that you would get with your more traditional sunglasses and some of the guesswork here. So, you know, our sunglasses, the Uswing sunglasses, eliminate the parallax issues, which give you really a consistent and more precise view of the green. So when you're looking at the slope of a green, you're seeing an improved viewpoint than even if you don't have anything on. Like, you know, for instance, I hate bright sunny days. I need sunglasses, period, when I'm playing. Doesn't matter if it's 85 degrees or 55 degrees, especially if you have a partly cloudy day. So not only can I, am I not squinting around the greens, I'm actually seeing the blades of the grass a bit better, and I can see the slopes a bit better, which in at the end of the day will improve your putting stroke. And we've even done some data. We had Mike Shannon, who's the one of the lead pros over at the TPC of Sawgrass. So he had about 90 golfers come to him over the last 6 months. And he basically put the glasses on, most of those golfers or all of those golfers, and had them putt with the glasses on and without the glasses on. And basically ran the same drill 95 times over with these golfers, about 35 of which are on the tour. So the average golfer saw an improvement in their aim of about a half inch, which at that level is the difference between making and missing a cut. It's the difference between winning second place money and fifth place money. Like, there's so many connotations where just a half inch gets a professional golfer, and that's why this is a premium product. For the everyday golfer like you and I, it's having something super light on your face that helps eliminate a lot of the parallax issues you would run into around the greens. And, you know, for even you and I, we're probably talking an inch and a half in terms of improving our aim on the putting green.
Wow. Yeah, I wanted to talk to you about that. I actually, and it's really funny, and Doris can attest to this. She's not on the line, but we'll get her back on the line later. I putted better than I've ever put in my life this past weekend, and it didn't even dawn on me. Maybe it was the sunglasses. I don't know. I'm not expecting it to continue, so that'll be the true test. But another question about that. I talked to some other sunglass manufacturers, and there's always that argument about polarized or not polarized. And many people say that polarized, you don't get the definition to be able to read the greens. And these are not polarized. So I get the feeling that you're a believer that for the greens, you do not want polarized sunglasses.
Correct. And, you know, I think everyone has their own take and their own opinion. We've decided to put some data behind a lot of this stuff now. And I think that's why we had Mike do this study over the last 6 months, do it in the same place at Sawgrass, on a place that's renowned for having tough conditions, tough greens to work with, and create some consistency and understanding. Like, he's talking to not only PGA Tour players, he's talking to high-level amateurs, he's talking to mini tour players. So we're seeing this across the board, not just with, you know, you and I going out there and thinking like we're doing something right for a change. He's doing it with golfers who absolutely are invested in every single piece of equipment that they have and every little subtle difference they pick up on.
Yeah, and you know, it's funny, though, also with my putting and having putt, like I said, better than I've ever putt. You don't know my history. I suffered with the yips for decades. My yips were so bad that people would cover their eyes because they were afraid it was contagious if they saw it. So I also spoke to many different pros, putting professionals, and tried the belly putter, tried the broomstick putter. I actually even putt with my eyes closed for a period of time. So your sunglasses wouldn't help with eyes closed putting too much, I don't think. But truly,
you would need like horse racing blinders instead.
Well, yeah, perhaps kind
of silver dollars and pizza dough.
But the funny thing is that the one thing that finally stuck that worked best, I'm a right-handed golfer. I now putt left-handed, and my putting improved significantly. But like I said, this past weekend with these sunglasses, I putt literally lights out. I played with Doris's husband, who's a low single-digit handicapper. It was the first time I've played with him, and he didn't know my history. He commented I was putting lights out. I have never heard that term. Like, wow. I say, for me, lights out means my eyes were closed and it was dark. Yeah. But I'm starting to believe what you're saying. I mean, I'm not a big believer in science. I'm not a great golfer. I'm not a great putter. But I'm telling you something. There's something here with my putting that I, and again, it just dawned on me now that maybe you guys and these sunglasses played a big part in it.
So the thing, another thing to notice is that the tint on these glasses is kind of grayish green,
yeah,
which is what pilots use.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not just an aesthetic choice. It's designed, the reason why pilots have that tint and the reason why we chose the tint for our glasses is there is a calming influence about that tint that allows you to stay calm and focused. Now, will Jack and Joe Doe notice it? Probably not. Will someone who's battling the yip notice it? Maybe, especially after I've told you that. and it's funny that you bring up Mickelson. Like, Mickelson, yes, was a guy who took forever to win his first major.
Mm-hmm.
Mickelson was a guy where, to your point, I had to learn to golf right-handed because until Phil came along, I think the lefty clubs were not as prevalent in the marketplace.
Uh-huh.
Mickelson was our ultimate early adapter. So the founder of the company, his name is Warren, played with Phil at a pro-am, and Phil forgot his glasses. He ended up playing with the Uswings one day, mm-hmm, and realized he really liked them. And then we saw him playing, not on our own volition, we just saw him with our glasses on at the match. And then he's continued to wear our glasses tournament after tournament after tournament, including last year's Masters, where everyone was trying to figure out,
yep,
why is this guy who's won all these majors wearing sunglasses when it's overcast and rainy in Augusta? Why is he playing well? And so Phil was asked about that after his final round last year, and he started talking about, no, these are glasses that are specifically designed for conditions like the, we even have an overcast series, which is the glasses he was playing with during that final round, where during overcast conditions where everyone thinks, okay, we're fine, the clouds are out, we do have glasses that deal with specific distortion elements that are brought on by overcast conditions. So Phil actually was the original early adopter here in North America for Uswing sunglasses, because he put them on, he realized they fit well over 18 holes. And, you know, they battle a number of different elements and conditions. And we've seen him for the last 5 years wearing Uswing sunglasses and really, you know, having people ask, you know, why is Phil wearing sunglasses when it's cloudy out? Why is Phil wearing these? Why is Phil doing this? Why is Phil doing that? We don't pay him, which is why,
oh, wow,
we don't really have him all over the website and all that as opposed to Rose and CT. But that was the backstory.
Very
that
interesting,
really got
but
us
he
America.
He also looks much cooler wearing them. I have to
that's
say
it.
That. So that,
yeah,
that's a help.
He doesn't look like he's closer to the senior tour now,
yes,
as opposed to winning majors.
Correct.
Because of the sunglasses.
Correct. And I have to also add, I've been, you know, living here in Florida. It's sunny most of the time, but it's been overcast the last few days, and I've been wearing them driving my car. And a major improvement as well. So I'm really enjoying them.
Refraction, man.
I know.
Light and the science behind it, to me,
all
is
good.
Fascinating.
It's
so.
All good. So anyway, we're just about out of time, but, you know, a lot of very valuable information on your website, uswingeyewear.com. I encourage the listeners to go there. You could purchase the sunglasses there. Would make an excellent gift. We've got Mother's Day, Father's Day just around the corner. I'm wearing them, so if you want to be like Dan and you want to putt better than you've ever putt before, you might want to give them a try. Uswingeyewear.com. And Jake, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Absolutely, and I'd be remiss not to mention, they are on Amazon now, so if you have Amazon
Excellent.
Prime and you need them this weekend, you can get them.
Perfect. Awesome. All right, thank you so much.
Thanks.
What we're going to do is going to take a very quick break. We're going to get Doris, back on the line. They don't help my brain, unfortunately, just my putting. But we'll get Doris back on the line, and we'll talk a little bit of travel. You won't want to miss it. Stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
A lot of men didn't. A lot of men died.
Hi, golf and travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to Jupiter.com. JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
Doris Muscarella here. When I'm not co-hosting the Golf at Travel show, I'm Southeast Florida's leading business and certified golf tournament consultant. I provide comprehensive solutions to all aspects of a golf tournament. From planning, management, marketing, administration, and logistics, I take care of the big picture or the smallest detail. With a passion for golf combined with years of experience as a golf tournament and event consultant, I organize events that exceed expectations and raise the bar of excellence. Your business or charity deserve no less. If you're ready to host a remarkable golf tournament that will leave your clients, players, donors, and spectators in awe, call me, Doris Muscarella, at 954-240-4853. That's 954-240-4853. Or simply visit my website, golfcharitytournaments.com. That's golfcharitytournaments.com.
Back, and one or two more good golf stories that I know you like, Mike, that I want to sneak in here. Of course, welcome back, Doris. Thanks for returning.
I'm here.
We were missing
her. I have a trivia question when you're done.
Oh, boy. All right. Boy. Okay. Love these.
So I saw this on Golf Digest. A Reddit person, somebody who posts things on Reddit.
A Redditor, if you will.
Yes, a Redditor. He took his wife golfing for the first time.
Okay.
And I guess the first hole is a short par 3, 95 yards. She hits her first golf shot ever on a golf course and puts it about an inch from the hole.
Wow, huh?
And he's never had a hole-in-one himself. She ended up, it was a 9-hole, I guess like an executive course. She ended up shooting a 63,
Holy cow.
Is more normal.
But still.
He shot a 29, but he's never had a hole-in-one. So he was afraid that she was going to get the hole-in-one before he did.
I love that combination, though.
So she's becoming an addict, right?
I'm sure. That's all it takes.
She's going to be chasing that dragon.
Better golf than gambling. It's a little bit cheaper.
Yeah, chasing that dragon for decades.
And also, there was a fellow by the name of Oki Stridham, and he's playing on the DP World Tour this past week, and the event is the Porsche Singapore Classic. This is last Thursday. And for a hole-in-one on this particular hole, the prize was a $200,000 Porsche Panorama Turbo E Hybrid.
Okay.
Hits his shot, it lips out. Goes around the hole and comes out.
Oh.
Could you imagine? So
wow.
Crazy.
So they gave him a Chevelle.
I guess so. So your turn, Doris. What do you got for us?
Okay, so trivia question.
Let's do it.
What golfer has shot the lowest score in a PGA Tour? And what's his name?
I don't remember, but I think the score is a 58. I believe there's a 58, right?
57.
57, okay.
Cristobal del Solar shoots a 57 for lower round, the lowest round in the PGA Tour history. Is that cool or what?
That's very cool. I could do that, but it's usually for the front nine.
Exactly, me too.
I don't even do that well playing Mario Golf on the easy setting.
Not easy. Amazing what these guys do. All right, a couple of quick bits of travel news. Of course, Boeing is still in the news, but now it seems that United, which flies a lot of Boeing planes, almost every day they're having a mishap. Congress is now looking into it. And also, those passengers that were on that Alaska Air where the door flew off.
Yes.
So they're not only suing, but now the FBI has told them that they may have been victims of a crime. So obviously, you know, with the cover up and that guy that maybe committed suicide, it's becoming a whole criminal kind of a thing.
Wow.
And that's probably why Boeing is not speaking too much, because their attorneys probably told them, you know, at your own peril, because you may end up sitting in a jail cell.
The liability on this is going to be
huge. I mean, money, they can write a check if they get fined. They can fix their stuff. But if there is criminal liability, you don't want to go to jail.
No, that's really never fun.
So, all right. Couple of deals on travel. Saw this on TravelZoo, TravelZoo.com. These days, you got to be a member. It costs maybe $50 a year. This one's for you, Doris. The Royal Sonesta in San Juan on sale right now, 45% off, including weekends, as little as $199 a night.
Wow.
Nice hotel.
Excellent.
Yeah, right on the beach, right by the airport. Great location. Also found on TravelZoo, a trip to Greece starting at $799 from Miami to Athens and Santorini. So that includes airfare, including to Santorini, accommodations, breakfast, hotel taxes, $7.99. Pretty good deal. Airfare deals, go to Google Flights and you can find these, googleflights.com. Cincinnati is on sale, as little as $165 from Fort Lauderdale.
Wow.
You might ask what's in Cincinnati, but it's actually Kentucky. Their airport is just over the border.
So if
you want to go see the horses, the Bourbon Trail, all that kind of stuff, some great golf.
I understand they have good fried chicken.
Also for you, Doris, Hamilton, Bermuda on sale. Fort Lauderdale, $298.
Wow.
Round trip,
when
nonstop.
When are we going?
I'm ready whenever you are. It's Bermuda Air. It's a new airline that's flying there.
I'll go.
Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada, from Orlando, $271. Nice this time of year. Hawaii's on sale from Florida in the 400s round trip. And that's
wait,
what
I'm sorry. Did you say the 400s for
400
Hawaii?
Round trip to Hawaii. Yes, 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 yes.
Oh, my God.
All right. besides choking to death, pardon me, still got the allergies.
Yeah, we're going around, Dan. A lot of people.
Thanks to our sponsor, Retirement Network Advisors, Jupiter Joe Thomas. Not just a friend, he advises me. Reach him at jupiterjoe.com. Tell him I sent you. Thanks to our guest, Jake Duhaime from Uswing Sunglasses, uswingeyewear.com. And, of course, our in-house golf tournament director, Doris Muscarella. If you have a golf event, corporate or charity that you'd like to do, the best way to reach Doris is?
Feel free to call me at 954-240-4853.
And next week, we're going to have a fellow by the name of Tim Bush on the show from a company called Chalkless. It's an incredible product that will keep your hands dry while golfing in the heat and humidity or rain. You won't want to miss that. So make sure that you do tune in again, same time, same place next week for another exciting episode of the Golf and Travel Show. In the meantime, hit them straight.
Every day is an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Shube. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.